Director Xu Bing made history when he produced the first film ever in the world without any actors or camera crews. Dragonfly's Eyes, a drama about a young woman's life, took all its footage from public surveillance videos. We all know the saying, there are only two things you can't avoid in life, death and taxes. But in China, surveillance camera has become the third thing that haunts people from cradle to grave. And guess what? With huge investments in artificial intelligence and big data, those cameras are doing a lot more than just recording. Today, I will show you the terrifying technology that China is using to watch and control people. This could be our future if technology and data are misused or fall into the wrong hands. I'm Sharon, and this is Straight Talk. China, a nation of 1.4 billion people, is living under the constant watchful eye of its government through the lenses of 650 million security cameras. That is one camera for every 2.5 people. This vast network of surveillance cameras is called Skynet. Yes, it is really called Skynet. In 2017, Xu Bing, director of Dragonfly's Eyes, set up 20 computer stations. His team worked round the clock for a year to record and download real-time surveillance footage, available or leaked into the public domain. They collected about 11,000 hours of footage and edited them into an 81-minute long story. Everything you see in the film included intimate and close-up shots, such as someone taking a shower, couples arguing, and friends chatting in a restaurant, was captured by security cameras. She'd been tracked down the people who were recorded in private settings to get their permission to use the footage in his film. But ordinary citizens are being recorded all the time and watched by God knows who. What's more, is the footage can even be used to track them down physically. Isn't this frightening? No wonder, after making the film, Xu Bing and his team no longer felt the same about their old way of life.
在我们这个团队工作了几个月以后呢，其实很有意思的，大家都有一个同样的感觉，就出门比以前都更加小心。因为呢，我们才知道原来这个世界呢是这样的。
In 2019, BBC journalist John Sutworth had a taste of the system himself.Police took a mugshot of him and gave him a few minutes to escape. Skynet caught him within 7 minutes.
Thank you very much.
Another college student did the same for his paper on Skynet. He was given 10 minutes to escape. The police tracked him down in just 5 minutes. It has been heavily advertised that Skynet keeps the public safe, and many Chinese seem to have accepted this claim.However, there are rising concerns and proof that these surveillance tools are being badly abused. Yet as of today, there are still no clear laws in China on the handling of private digital data. Could it be that this is somewhat desired? Experts believe that a major reason for the lack of security in the Chinese surveillance system is that Chinese companies installed backdoors in their security cameras to allow the authorities to tap in.Foreign buyers have gradually come to understand this practice. Now, many countries in the West refuse to buy security cameras made in China. Because this intense degree of digital surveillance has been going on for a decade in China, the data collected is sufficient to support more advanced technology, such as facial recognition. Nowadays, there's also gait recognition that can recognize people based on how they move, and it comes in handy when facial recognition simply isn't possible. This means that you can't even hide behind a mask. And actually, facial recognition is so advanced today that the accuracy is close to 98%, even if a mask is worn. In China, many schools have installed AI cameras to monitor students' behavior and level of concentration.In 2019, journalists from Wall Street Journal visited a primary school just outside of Shanghai where students took lessons wearing headbands and under the watch of surveillance cameras. The headband detects brain waves and measures each student's level of concentration. Red means engaged, blue distracted, white means the device is disconnected.Readings and real-time images are instantly transmitted to both the class teacher and the children's parents. As you can see, the pressure has already started building in primary schools. Just a few days ago, a well-known high school in Henan province listed names of students and their misdeeds on the school's official social media account. These students are in the equivalent of our sixth form, so they're at the delicate age of 17 or 18. So what are the misdeeds that are worthy of public shaming? Dozing off during class, fidgeting, applying hand lotion in class, combing hair, eating snacks, and so on. The school said behavioral points would be deducted for these terrible misdeeds. Can you imagine receiving public condemnation over these things? These things are just part of being a teenager. There is little room to be different or to accommodate those who just need to take a bit of time out. The authorities, in this case, the teachers and the parents, have decided down to the finest details what the children must and must not do, thanks to the surveillance technology. You either conform or suffer. The public shaming sparks an outcry from Chinese netizens. The school finally apologized over the public posting, but not the monitoring itself. Besides dialing up the pressure in the classrooms, the AI surveillance technology has had some home buyers worried too. Can you see some people wearing helmets to a property viewing? Why are they doing this? Can you think of a reason? Well, 80% of property developers in China are said to have installed facial recognition cameras in their marketing suites. The use of those cameras is no longer about security, it is about business. They use cameras to identify their customers. For instance, how many times they have visited, whether they are accompanied by agent, etc. Why is this type of information important? It will tell the companies how keen or how prepared you are as a potential buyer. If the salespeople find a match in their database, they're able to know more about you. They will quickly learn your financial situation, your background, and your experience in the property market. They will see the best way to get you to buy the property. Some developers offer discounts to first-time visitors. The company will go through their surveillance records to confirm if this is indeed your first visit. The difference in prices could be as much as £30,000, so it becomes important to those who are aware of the tricks to stay unrecognizable, no matter how ridiculous they may look to others. Facial recognition is used to an excessive degree in China. Some public toilets even use facial recognition to dispense a few squares of free toilet paper to cut on waste. If this is not enough paper for you, I'm sorry, you'll have to wait for another 15 or 20 minutes before you are allowed any more. Those controls may sound trivial to us, but when you are living under this kind of constant surveillance, they will add up. Many do not realize that their face has become the key to a host of information about their private lives. When they are out and about in the city, their face is leaking information. Scary, isn't it? As if this wasn't all Orwellian enough, the Chinese government says, through these technologies, it is able to predict crimes before they happen using algorithms and make preemptive strikes. This worries many, considering the human rights abuses the Chinese government has committed. The Chinese government is indeed known to have used this as a way to control dissidents and ethnic groups. Xinjiang is under heavy surveillance. Police place Uyghurs who they consider dangerous on a blacklist. If they set foot in a neighborhood they're not supposed to visit, an alarm goes off. Huawei and McVie jointly developed the recognition software that could be used to identify Uyghurs. Their technology makes ethnic cleansing possible. Yes, that's the same Huawei you buy your phone from. Despite such an all-inclusive and penetrative surveillance system, China is still a Tier 3 country for human trafficking, meaning China does not meet even the minimum standards for the elimination of human trafficking and is not making significant efforts to do so. Even with 650 million cameras, there is still a large number of people going missing, including children and women. In 2019, France became the first country in EU using facial recognition as part of nationwide digital ID scheme. Are you worried that this might soon come to the UK? As always, I'd love to hear what your thoughts are. Please share them down below. If you enjoyed today's video, please remember to like it and share it. Don't forget to hit subscribe and the bell so you won't miss future episodes. Thank you for watching and see you soon.